Did you know Seattle is poised to completely disrupt healthcare? I love Rocket Boy. This represents Seattle, part aerospace, part grunge, part scientist, part computer geek. You're not quite sure what he's going to do, but you know it's going to be disruptive. Let's talk about another disruption, wearable health devices. So how many people in the audience have purchased a wearable health device? And how many of you are wearing them right now? That's not bad. That's not bad. Well, I am super excited about these devices, and they're a failure. 20% of Americans buy such devices, and only half of us wear it on a daily basis. And half of us will completely discard them in the next 12 to 16 months. So this is a market failure. But from this, we can learn a few things. So what's the point? The point is, all of us that purchased one of these devices bought into the promise of a healthier lifestyle. But what we got was a bunch of data, a lot of data, and a bunch of really snazzy apps. And a feeling that there's got to be something more to this. Something is truly missing. So what we want is actually insights and guidance on our wellness. We want wellness. And wellness is the healthy balance of our mind, body, and spirit. And so these devices don't connect the data to actual wellness. And we expect, as consumers of healthcare, to actually get wellness as a benefit from that care. And this is missing. And so our healthcare system is a mess. No, this is not your annual eye exam. Please don't try, but understand that it is a mess. We have out-of-control costs that are driving us towards bankruptcy. We have an escalating elderly population with increasing longevity in life and a shortage of doctors. This is a big mess, headed right our way. And I don't know about you, but when I think about my healthcare, I feel like this guy. Right? How did we get here? Right? Because the system that we have today was designed to treat the sick, not to keep a majority of us that are well, well. So we're in the back, crushed between the seats. We don't have our seatbelt on. You can't see out the window. And we're probably digging around for some spare change at the same time, right? I feel like I'm just along for the ride. So when I go to the doctor, like many of you, once a year for my annual checkup, a recent study said that the average doctor spends just over an hour of their day on preventative care. And that same study says the guidelines for that same set of patients, he needs to spend almost his entire day on preventative care. And this is your wellness. So think about this for a second. You go to the doctor once a year for 1 hour, and you receive less than 20% of the guidance on your wellness. That's incredible. So what we have is not health care. We have sick care. And what we all are looking for when we bought these devices was well care. Well care puts the individual at the center of healthcare, and it focuses on their wellness. It stays focused on the healthy balance of your mind, body, and spirit. So luckily, in Seattle, we are on the path to well care. This is Dr. Lee Hood and Dr. Nathan Price at the Institute for Systems Biology, and they are conducting what they call the 100,000 Person Wellness Project. And this is a massive study of individuals' wellness that includes everything from gene sequencing to analyzing body function to monitoring your personal lifestyles. They believe in 4P medicine. This 4P stands for patient participation, personalized, predictive, and preventative. It's all about keeping people well and keeping an eye on their wellness so that they don't cascade into a chronic condition that you can't come back from. So studies like this create a tremendous amount of data. Data that needs to be analyzed, interpreted, and have insight discovery. So fortunately, we live in Cloud City. Seattle is the undisputed leader in cloud computing, advanced analytics, and data-driven intelligence. We have the talent and the infrastructure at our fingertips to take the data that comes from these massive studies and turn them into predictive health models. This is pretty incredible stuff. If we spend as much time on well care as Amazon spends on figuring out all of our buying habits, data from studies like this will be stunning. Speaking of stunning, this is Dr. Stan Riddell at the Fred Hutch Cancer Research Center. He recently presented on his team's personalized therapies that are literally curing cancer. Just a few years ago, the state-of-the-art therapies were only demonstrating remission rates of 20% at best. And recent advances at the Fred Hutch are now showing remission rates of 80% and above. And this is with patients that are the sickest of the sick, that have rejected all other therapies. This is some pretty stunning work right in our front yard. So not only is this region poised to influence well care, but this is going to be driven by you. Not only because it's personalized, but because all of you that purchased a wearable healthcare device has already voted for it. This well care is going to be driven by us, by our participation, and collectively by our voices demanding a better system of healthcare. A future with devices that not only collect your data, but give you insights and guidance on your wellness, and perhaps a watch that tells you when it's time to go see the Fred Hutch team and get your immune system booster before it's too late. This is the opportunity of our region to be at the epicenter of completely disrupting healthcare. And this is the future of Rocket Boy.